His presentation's topic today is acute care of sudden sensory neural hearing loss by Yamatoma new scalpel acupuncture as the single treatment. This is a case report. Now let's welcome Dr. Gao.
Ladies and gentlemen, konnichiwa, annyeonghaseyo. Welcome to Taipei. I have pleasure to introduce about the case report about using YNSA to treat sudden sensorineural hearing loss patients. If everyone has questions, please ask me as soon as possible. Okay, let me introduce but outline briefly. Why I choose the sensorineural loss as a topic, and how do I treat the patient with YNSA? Finally, I will introduce the conclusion. Background. Sudden sensorineural hearing loss is an otological emergency defined as rapid hearing loss which seriously affects patient's social life. The definition of sensorineural hearing loss is that a rapid hearing loss of more than 30 decibels in at least 3 continuous test frequency occurring 3 days. Large-scale case studies performed in China, Japan, Europe, and the United States have shown that the SSHL typically occurs between 40 and 55 years of age, which is higher about 39.5% with equal sex distribution. The prevalence in the age group 18 to 30 is about 16% with a growth trend. The hearing loss in SSHO is often accompanied with dizziness, vertigo, nausea, and vomiting. A newer incidence of 5 to 20 people per 100,000 population has been defined. Yamamoto new scalp acupuncture, YNSA, is present by Japanese physician Toshikazu Yamamoto. He discovered an independent acupuncture system and presented at a Japanese Ryotaku Congress in Osaka in 1973. This method is based on somatotopes rather than traditional Chinese acupuncture points. YNSA is very popular in Japan, Europe, and United States now. This is Dr. Yamamoto Toshikazu. YNSA provided rapid relief pain of the locomotor system and a neurological disorder. This therapy has 4 main systems: basic points, sensory points, brain points, and Y points. This is basic point. Basic point can treat for a locomotor system. The ABC points treat upper limb and cervical disorder. DEFG points treat lower limbs, thoracic and lumbar disorder. HIJK points are assistant points. This is sensory points. Here are eye points, nose points, ear points, and mouth points. But because the graph is in German, so the ear points is here. And then these points can treat facial feature disorders. And this is brain points. Here are cerebrum points, cerebellum points, and basal ganglion points. The brain points can treat neurological disease. And this is Y points. There are 12 points, for example, the heart points, hovers here, and the lung points, and the kidney points. But I think the points can only treat the organ disease rather than the state of internal organs. In Chinese, we call it 脏象. There are four methods of treating SSHL. The first one is story therapy. It's also the first line therapy of SSHL. The second one is early hyperbaric oxygenation therapy. The third one is electroacupuncture. And the fourth one is traditional Chinese medical acupuncture. Despite many studies on above four therapies for treating SSHL, no study about YNSA as a primary and salvage therapy of SSHL has been carried out. This case report details for successful use of YNSA treatment in young patients in acute phase of SSHL. Let me see the case representation. The patient was a 28-year-old woman who had left ear SSHL in July of 2018. Her symptoms are tinnitus and hearing loss at 78 decibels without fullness, vomiting, and the other symptoms. She received steroid treatment, but her hearing didn't improve. Then she started YNSA treatment. The YNSA treatment applying to the follow acupuncture somatotopes. Basic point, we use 8 points. And sensory points, we use 4 tinnitus points. I will show that in another PowerPoint. And the brain points, we use the cerebral points, cranial nerve point number 8, the vestibulocochlear nerve. And the Y point, we use kidney point. And the other point, I use the isomatotopes, master key point tinnitus. Each treatment session lasts 20 minutes. Okay, this one is A point, and the cerebral point, and this is tinnitus point. This one is cranial nerve number 8, and this is kidney point. The patient received the treatment every week. During the first treatment, the patient felt great improvement in hearing. In second treatment, the patient can hear high frequent voice. In third treatment, her tinnitus was relieved and hearing loss improved from 78 decibel to 45 decibel. In fourth treatment, her hearing loss improved from 45 decibel to 13 decibel. And the otolaryngology physician said her SSHL was cured. This is a graph of the pure tone audiometry. The blue line is the patient first time he come to the clinic. And the red line is the third time. And the green line is the last time final examination. Everyone can see that the green line is almost above 25 decibel. Discussion. SSHL is not identified and assumed to be either viral or idiopathic. The prognosis of SSHL is great, and it's common that patients experience hearing improvement within days. Patients with no improvement in hearing within 2 weeks, and those having hearing loss for more than 2 to 3 months are likely to become permanently deafness. The previous studies also have documented that the acupuncture could be improved in hearing in late SSHL. Ng and colleagues reported that 70 SSHL in cases in which a 3 week conventional therapy failed. After about 7 days of treatment, 8 of them had improvement of more than 20 decibel in hearing. In our study by Zhao, 63 patients with SSHL for at least 1 month were recruited. After 14 treatments within about 30 days, the average hearing threshold increased by 70 decibel. Dr. Nanbing Wang reported 2 case reports that patients suffered from SSHL for 1 week. They treated by electroacupuncture for 5 and 7 days. Then the patient's hearing loss had developed. In this case, One is say treatment can improve the hearing loss more than traditional acupuncture. The treatment period is also shorter, but we still have limitation. Because we treated patients in the Chinese medicine clinics, we couldn't do the hearing loss examination conveniently. We can only ask the patients go to the otolaryngology clinics or hospitals for help. If possible, we still need more clinical trials of effectiveness between traditional acupuncture and YNSA. This case showed that ASHHO responded well to YNSA. Moreover, YNSA can also eliminate the tinnitus in the affected ear. YNSA may be worth trying in patients with SSHL who do not respond to routine medical treatment or traditional Chinese acupuncture. In line with previous studies, the current report indicates that future clinical trials are needed to improve the efficacy of YNSA on hearing loss and the accompanying symptoms among SSHL patients. Okay, these are my references. Thanks for listening of my presentation. Wish you have a good time in Taiwan. Thank you very much.